First of all, great to talk to you. I got a text from you when you were on the way here, yeah, and it was so loud in there. I'm like, I'll call you after. I didn't know you were like hosting for Showtime.
Because I'm not hosting. I was just happened to be on stage, but I was coming here to see Derrick James. Say what's up
to
my
and they
guy.
Put you on there?
Well, I was just, yeah, they were like, hey, you want to go?
Oh, home? That's I said, cool. Yeah, I thought they brought you to host.
No.
Well, I don't remember how long ago it was, but it was many years ago, maybe 8, maybe 9 years ago. I went somewhere and I interviewed you. And you were talking to me about the Charlos back then, before they were famous, before they were champions.
Yeah.
You were like, I like these kids, I like the twins. And now look, Jermell is about to fight for all the belts at 154.
Yeah, I like the fact that, you know, he came in with power, and obviously he got a lot of skills, but now he's adding skills with the power, which is, you just never know what punch can really hurt you. I mean, you know, a lot of people is, he's definitely being hunted. You know what I mean? Because he's the champ, he got the belts and all the stuff. You know, he got a big personality. But at the same time, you still just can't run in there. You know what I mean? You just can't run up in there. Then he's liable to catch you with something that, you know, that they've been working on.
He's the lightest he's ever been, but he's in great shape. He's rock solid. And he wasn't even rushing to eat. He was cool.
Yeah, that's crazy. Great. I mean, I miss being in shape like that. I was watching him. You could tell he's a super shape.
So what do you think happens tomorrow?
Tomorrow, I think potentially. I don't think he's gonna go the distance because I just think both these guys are gonna be throwing haymakers, and you know, I feel like I think Charlo does have more power, but it's gonna be a great fight, man. I think Castano is very professional, and you know, he's very excited, and I think and Charlo's just getting better.
You've always been a huge boxing fan. Who are some of your favorite fighters? Because I know Manny Pacquiao, you had a chance to meet him.
Yeah, Manny. Yeah.
Mayweather.
Well, Mayweather's my favorite, and then Canelo. All time, you know. I like Mayweather. I think Mayweather is incredible. You know what I'm saying? And I think he's a clean fighter. You know what I mean? All right, Derek.
Now, I don't know. Derek, did you know, I think you must be the only person to be in there with Michael Jordan and Kobe. What's the story with the ribs? Did you break his rib or did he?
No, it was a mistake.
What happened?
It was a mistake.
No, but on whose side?
We play hard.
Right.
Basketball. You know, Michael's like
a competitive
guy we know.
Uh-huh.
And then I was 19, but you know, they didn't realize how tough I was. And we was grinding.
He tried to box you out?
He was grinding, fighting for position was an accident.
And you broke his rib?
It was an accident.
No, but it happened. But what did he tell you? Did he respect you more afterwards?
He always asked me to come back and play.
That's awesome.
He always like to say, hey, make sure you come back to the gym. Which is like a compliment. So we all go to people's bar, pick up the ball. Come back.
And that's huge because you got drafted by Chicago, right?
Yeah.
And for him to be the god in Chicago, it's a big compliment. 19 years old, breaking Jordan. Okay, let's go. Last thing. Your favorite moment with Kobe?
Oh, favorite moment with Kobe when he came to my room was like, he said, yo, play some beats for me. But I want to write some rhymes and we rap for like 2 hours. That was
he had skills. When he was 18, he had a rap album.
Yeah, it's a good album. Yeah, it's a good album.
All right, I remember the song Champion that you had.
Yep.
All right, there you have it. Let's go.
Tell me,
I was on your side. That you were willing to be a tune-up for Canelo. Can you talk about that?
Yeah, you know, I'm going to keep getting dodged, you know. It is what it is. Thank I don't got to fight Canelo to be one of the greatest fighters that go down in history. If you don't fight me, it's all good. Shit happens in Canelo.
Was there any level of...
Ellie Sekback reporting for ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Sekback reporting.